Hello, is it audible? Awesome. I was going to start off by asking how many of you have heard of 3D printer, but she did that for me. okay, how many of you have used a 3D printer before? Okay, that's awesome. That's really awesome. So you would know how a 3D printer works. Okay, and you would also know that a 3D printer, the technology of 3D printing is not 2 days old or 2 weeks old or not even 2 years old. In fact, it's almost 30 years old. And this is the first patent filed by Mr. Charles W. Hull on 3D printing. It was in the year of 1984. It's been for about 3 decades now. And the evolution that it has taken is used so many innovations of so many makers and companies. And some of them are unbelievable. These shoes that you see are 3D printed. Now there's technology that will scan your feet and print out shoes exactly for your soul so that they become perfect soulmates. And then apart from shoes, there is cars. Cars are 3D printed now. So about 5 years from now, maybe you go to Maruti and ask for a 3D printed car and they say no. And you say, okay, fine, I'll do it myself. Houses. Houses are 3D printed now. Can you imagine that those houses were printed within 24 hours? 10 of them. 10 of those houses were 3D printed in 24 hours. Even dresses. Even dresses can be 3D printed. That's a 3D printer in the NASA International Space Station, orbiting the Earth about 400 kilometers upwards from where we are right now. So imagine the possibility of whatever I showed before. Shoes, cars, houses, even food and even dresses that can be 3D printed in space now. So exploring space just got a lot easier. How 3D printing works? It starts from an idea that all of us have, your idea. It's converted to an object, a 3D object on a computer. That computer file is then prepared for a 3D printer and then it's given to a 3D printer. That just prints out the file, the magic happens right there. And then I have a short clips of the video of how it prints. Okay, I got into 3D printing because I was an inventor by heart and I love making things. And about 2 years back, I was watching this movie, Iron Man 1, I think everyone would have seen it. There's a scene where Tony Stark gets captured and then he's in the cave and he wants to break free. But he thinks of a way out and he tries to make his first Iron Man suit. What appears to be in a couple of minutes is that if someone tries to do it the way he does, it takes about 2 months. What was very curious about that is, what I felt very curious about that is, why didn't he have a 3D printer there? He could have gotten out the next day. So I went online, since I was a maker, I was a DIY enthusiast. I bought a DIY kit. That was the first printer that I built. That was about 2 years back. The kit took about 2 days to build. 2 days, two sleepless nights. And I built it. It's awesome. It looks awesome. So before I started to print, I knew it's not going to work because the first time I built it, it's not going to work. So the next day I tried to print a few objects and that's how horrible that was. Really horrible. So what I did, I didn't give up. I started researching on my printer, started working on how I can make it better. How I can use technology that is so accessible and make it available for common people. I started building prototypes. I started enhancing on the printer that I have right now. And I built the Z Spider. That's the new latest model. And here's a photo of it. That's the photo of Z Spider. And if anybody asks, what's the precision of your printer? I don't have to tell anything. I just show them this photo. That's the precision that is achieved by our 3D printer. We have taken many projects for 3D printing when we started the company. And some of the very interesting projects were, none of the projects are the same, you know, because everybody has different ideas. None of the ideas are the same ever. So someone comes to us and says, we have an idea, we have a new project. We're like always excited because it's never the same. It can't be the same. So one of the interesting projects of 3D printing is you can 3D print a 3D printer using a 3D printer. That is a 3D printer that was 3D printed out by our 3D printer. And then it's like, if you say it's like making babies. So this is the photo that the customer or the our client sent us, and then we are like, boy, graduation, finally. So what else would I like to emphasize on is your ideas, you become a doodle. Whatever ideas that you have, you put it on a piece of paper. That's where you stop, right? You put it on a piece of paper, then you wish that you would do more about it. But 3D printing here can change it. It's if you can draw it, you can make it. At this point, I started to look at things very differently. How differently? Now, if I go to a store, if I see something, I don't go and ask if I can buy it. I look at it and I ask to myself if I can make it. That's how 3D printing is. It changed my entire perspective of how I look at things. This is a whistle, a working whistle that was 3D printed out. This was given to my dad. My dad was leaving for EBC, that is Everest Base Camp trekking. The night before that, I wanted to give him something special, something memorable. So I 3D printed out a keychain with Swami written on it. That's my surname, my dad's surname as well. So I gave this to him, and then in the morning, I wasn't up when he left. So I kept it on his bag, and I said, happy journey, have a nice trip, have a successful trip. And then this, that's my brother and my sister-in-law. They have been married for quite some time now. They stay in UK. Last December, it was their anniversary. So my brother loves a lot of mixtures and everything. South Indian, right? So he likes spices. So what my dad and my mother gave was all these mixtures and sweets and everything. So I wanted to give something different, which they will possess, you know, that no one else would. No one else would give such a gift. That's a 3D printed photo. That's a 3D printed photo, actually. And some of the projects that we undertake are not necessarily from an idea. If you have a object that has broken from a piece, or broken from a system that you want to fix, but otherwise, if you want to get it from the company itself, it's going to cost a lot, because they're going to say they have to import it from Germany or USA when we very well know that it's right sitting right there in the company. So when we got a client that said that he wanted to prototype this model, and then we said, okay, cool, we'll do it. And then we 3D scanned that prototype in black, and we printed out the model in white that actually fits. That cost him less than the shipping charges that would have costed if he had actually imported it. This is another client that is taking a selfie of 2015 glasses that we 3D printed out and we showcased in an event. There's nothing more, there's no more happiness to see when a customer uses your prototype to take a selfie. This is a mobile stand. I bet you wouldn't have seen it anywhere else. Correct? Okay, that's my mom's phone. I gave this stand to my mom, and then she got so excited and she showed it to everybody else, and then everyone got in. They just started asking where you got it, obviously, right? Where you got it? Everybody wants to have one. So my mom told my son 3D printed this out, and they were like, what is 3D printing and everything. Then instead of telling what 3D printing is, what my mom did was told me to make one more and give it to them. So right now I just gave 6 of them. And this is a DJ. I don't think you can see his face, but that's a DJ. So he came from USA, he came approached us, and he said he loves studs. As you can see, he loves putting studs and everything. So he told us he's not finding a design that he wanted for the studs. So we told him, okay, cool, we'll do it. What's the design that you want? He said he wants a musical note on it. And then he said, okay, I have some other work nearby, I'll finish and come back. So within half an hour, we designed it, 3D printed out, and kept it ready. He was so excited that he said he's going to make a couple more designs and come back to us so that we can 3D print it out. Because it's something different that nobody has. This is the TEDxBNMIT keychains. This is one of the projects that we undertook that changed the way we think 3D printing is, the potential of 3D printing changed our lives as well as the people involved in the project. A doctor, a maxillofacial surgeon. How many of you here know what a maxillofacial surgeon is? Okay, only three of them. So even I'm in the majority, so I didn't know. So I googled what is maxillofacial surgeons, and I got to know that these doctors deal with jaws and fish. So he told us about his patient who had an unfortunate event in his life, and he got cancer, and some part of his face had to be removed. A majority of his face had to be removed due to cancer if he had to survive. And then he told us that he's a very socially active person, and he would love to get his face recreated. So doctor said, is there anything that we can do with 3D printing? We didn't know that we possessed such powers. With 3D printing, just an idea. So we told, okay, fine, we'll take the output from a CT scan. Those are DICOM files. So the DICOM files are converted into 3D model. As you can see, a majority of his face is missing. I have another model of the 3D printed part. So this model, we gave this to the doctor. This doctor, that's the 3D printed part. The doctor then molded the defective area with wax. And then later, he created a template, an acrylic template of the defective area. Right now, that acrylic template is being sent to a bioprocesses manufacturer, where that acrylic template is going to be manufactured in a biocompatible material, so that 6 weeks to 6 to 10 weeks from now, the patient can live a normal and social life that he wishes to live. That's how powerful 3D printing is. This is this quote by Steve Jobs. I challenge every one of you here to challenge the usual, to push the limits, and to be curious, because the people who are crazy enough to think are the ones who change the world. Thank you.